Hey, I'm Allison from Learning at the Primary Pond. I'm a literacy specialist, and in this video, I'm going to share with you one secret that is super helpful in motivating kids to read decodable texts and also just getting them engaged. And the good news is that it's a relatively simple secret, and I have a solution for you. Before we dive in, though, want to make sure you're subscribed to my channel. If you haven't yet, hit subscribe, but then also hit the little bell so that you're notified every time I post a brand new video about teaching literacy in K-2. Okay, so first let's talk decodable text and just make sure that we're all on the same page. When I say decodable text, what I'm referring to are texts that are controlled for specific phonics patterns and often specific high frequency words as well. So let's say, for example, you're teaching the CH digraph. Well, then you pull in a decodable text that has a lot of words with the CH digraph in it. What you will also want to make sure is that the decodable text has words that the kids can decode from other things they've already been taught. So for example, maybe you're teaching CH and the kids know short vowels, but they don't know long vowels yet. Well, a good decodable book that matches your scope and sequence will not have long vowels. It'll only have words with short vowels because that's what you've already taught. It will also probably have some high frequency words and maybe some review words from previous patterns. So that's what a decodable text is. If you're already using decodable text in the classroom, I would love to know. So right now in the comments section, go in there and just type the word decodable so that I know if you're using decodable text in the classroom. Okay, so now let's talk about the secret to getting them engaged and motivated and wanting to read decodable text. Many times kids will already want to read decodable texts because they contain phonics patterns that they know. They can figure this stuff out. They can experience reading success. But sometimes maybe you have some more reluctant students, or maybe, you know, they think that a text is boring, or maybe they think that it's babyish for whatever reason. So this trick will help motivate them. And like I said, the trick is simple. All it is to capitalize upon what kids already like and choose those topics for the decodable texts that they're reading. So now I'm going to give you an example of some decodable texts that I know most kindergarten, first grade, and second grade students will love. So these are the decodable safari passages in my Learning at the Primary Pond Teachers Pay Teachers store. Kids love reading about animals, but the problem is that so many animal books have really challenging language, very advanced words, and so they're not very decodable for most young readers, but these are different. So the way these are structured, I'll just start with a kindergarten example, is that the vast majority of the words are controlled for phonics patterns, and there's actually a table of contents in the product so that you can look and see, like, oh, I want to practice this pattern, we're going to read about this. So you can find the skill very easily. They're controlled for the phonics patterns, and then they also have some basic high frequency words in them. And then there are a couple of words that are underlined here. In this text, it's only tiger and stripes. And all you do as the teacher, when you introduce the text, you just say, hey, I'm going to point out two words to you kindergartners. This is the word tiger. Find it in your passage. Read it, tiger. This is the word stripes. These are two words you're going to find as you read. That way, the kids aren't being asked to use phonics knowledge that they haven't even acquired yet, right? Because these words have, like, you know, the STR blend, three-letter blend, silent E, long vowel, all things that they haven't been taught yet. So all you do is pre-teach these two words and you're done. So kids still get access to this really engaging, meaningful, fun topic, but, you know, you're still able to talk about the topic and keep the rest of the words decodable. So this is an example of a kindergarten version. And then here's an example of a second grade passage. As you can see, there's more text here. Again, there's a couple of words that are underlined. There's some text features. It's more complex. But same idea. The words are restricted to those phonics patterns and high frequency words that you've already taught, but very engaging, motivating for the kids to read. Again, I feel like motivation is so key, and kids love reading about animals. So now let's go a little bit more in depth and talk about, like, how I introduce these passages in the decodable safari and, like, what other things you can do with them. Because honestly, there's so much more you can do than just have them read the passage. There's so much great comprehension, vocabulary, other kinds of work that can be done, in addition to, of course, phonics practice, which is a primary reason for reading the decodable text. Okay, so let me grab the lesson plan. This is an example of a lesson plan, and in the decodable safari, it will have, I would say, like, more than you would normally use in a lesson because there's options, like optional follow-up activities, optional things to talk about. So you definitely have choices, but let me kind of go through like what you might do in a typical lesson. So the lesson plan here is gonna first, of course, tell you like what phonics skills are being covered so that you know what to talk about with the kids and make sure that you're matching the right kids to the right text. There's also a list of high frequency words. That way you can look and see like, okay, do my students know these? Is it an appropriate text for them? And if they don't know one of the words, can I just pre-teach it? Obviously, we don't want a ton of words that they can't read. We don't want to have to be pre-teaching for 10 minutes before they actually read. But this lesson plan makes it really easy to determine if this is a good fit text for your students or not. The lesson plan then explains how to activate background knowledge. And these are really unique because the introduction will have you reading about the animal. Sometimes when you're doing decodable text, as I've mentioned, they're very simple and kind of like limited in what you can say. And so like with this one, this is for the rhinoceros hornbill. And it says, today we're going to be reading about the rhinoceros hornbill. It lives in Southeast Asia. It has an unusual and colorful beak. It has a bright horn above its beak. Another name for beak is bill. The rhinoceros hornbill finds food in trees and eats fruits, berries, insects, frogs, bats, and more. So before you do that, you actually ask the kids, hey, do you know this animal? Do you have any background knowledge on it? And then you read this thing that's kind of like getting their brains ready to read, providing that background knowledge. At that point, you would then like pre-teach any of the words that I was talking about, words that they wouldn't be able to decode yet. And again, you don't want to have like tons and tons of those pre-teach words. You just want to have a couple. Let's see. Oh, often with these decodable safari texts, you're going to have some kind of teaching point that has to do with the text feature because that's a big thing. So like here, you might talk about, oh, this is a map. This is a key, right? What does the key mean? The key is telling us that gibbons live in these parts of the world. So there's going to be some sort of work with the text feature. Again, this is a little bit different from some decodable texts that are just very basic. This is really good content stuff, building that background knowledge, building those comprehension skills. So the kids are then going to read the text. They'll each have their own copy. If the text is a lot for them to read, you could chunk it. So you say, okay, I want you to read the first two paragraphs and stop, and then we'll discuss, and then you finish it. Some of them are just, you know, a little bit shorter. And so once you've pre-taught the words, they can decode and they're good to go. So you know your students and just kind of base it on the length of the passage as well. So the kids read, and then what the lesson plan has is it has them retelling the text. It has comprehension questions to ask. It has some vocabulary questions. Again, there may be a little bit more than you have time for, but that is totally okay. Just wanted to give you some different options. Another thing that you want to do is find any words that kids struggled with while they were reading the text. You know, obviously if it's a word that's underlined, you just remind them of what it is. The point is not for them to decode, but like, let's say for example, they were supposed to be able to read the word bugs and bats, and maybe they struggled with the plural. Take that word, write it on a little whiteboard, and practice decoding it with the group. So that's where observing your kids really comes into play, because you want to see like, what are they struggling with so that you can then address those challenges after the lesson. So just to recap, after the lesson, we're doing a little quick comprehension, vocabulary discussion, and then again, applying those phonics and decoding skills to make sure that they really, you know, can be successful with the passage next time they read it, because rereading is amazing for fluency. You're not going to want to read each passage more than once, and the kids are going to want to read them more than once because they love reading about animals. So it could be that maybe next lesson you come back and they read the text again, or it could be that maybe this becomes an independent activity that they reread on their own. Totally up to you, but rereading is really important. Okay, so after that, it's kind of really up to you how much more you want to do with the passage. These passages come with, in the Decodable Safari, they come with these comprehension question sets. This is like an easier version. It's first grade, so of course, like there's like a very simple multiple choice. There's not too much going on. With the second grade, it's a little bit more advanced. With kindergarten, it's even easier. So the level of the question sets will really vary. This could be maybe you do your lesson and then you say, okay, first graders, I want you to, as your independent activity, reread this text and then fill out the questions. Boom. Super easy independent worker center, and it's based on what you've already done together as a group. Okay, so let's see. We talked about the question sets. They also all come with some sort of writing and drawing activity. Very simple, just to try to get the kids to synthesize what they've learned. And they will, of course, enjoy drawing and writing about their animals that they read about. They might take it home. They might share it with a friend. Maybe a different group didn't get to read about that animal. So if you can give them a little audience, that is always amazing too. You can also, and every single different animal or every single different passage will have a different one, but you may want to do some work with like graphic organizers or other comprehension skills. So here's an example. This was for an emu, and the categories are can, likes, has, and it's almost like a word bank, but it's more like a phrase bank here. And so like they have to match an emu can swim and kick. They write that there, an emu can run fast. So they're using the terms and the information they learned in the passage to then fill out one of these. And these are all different throughout the Decodable Safari resource. Some of them have to do with like text features. So like after they've read about the leopard tortoise, they can take that information and like do a make your own caption type thing. So we have photos and then they write their captions. Here's an example that we use sometimes. So it's like main idea and then details. So they cut it out, main idea and then details. So just all kinds of different things to get them practicing these concepts. But if you've used other decodable texts before, then you might notice that there's just a lot more here provided for you, because not only are decodable texts great for, of course, getting them to practice those phonic skills, high frequency words, but if you choose high quality decodable texts, there's so much comprehension and vocabulary work to be had. You don't have to only reserve that stuff for read alouds. You can do it with decodable texts too. All right, so I hope this little peek at the Decodable Safari was helpful. Again, I know your kids will love reading about animals. Mine always do, and I enjoy it too, right? Like it's that much more fun to teach the lessons when the kids are engaged. If you want to take a peek at my Decodable Safari resources, I've got them for kindergarten, first grade, and second grade. Go to the link that I'm going to include with this video. It'll be from the Learning at the Primary Pond Teachers Pay Teacher store. You can read more about it, kind of download the preview, see if it's something that would be helpful to you. And of course, let me know if you have any questions. Hope this video was helpful. Thanks so much for watching. Hit the like button, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.